Namaskar. What is happening? Our walking is not normal anymore. After the age of 30, 35, I see people limping and walking. That knee joint is taking the whole weight of our body. It's the largest joint and that is getting affected. Who is responsible for this? This problem can come in old age because you have used your body quite a lot. Your joints are also quite having wear and tear. But what about young age? Somewhere something is wrong. And who is responsible? You yourself. Make some changes in your life. Otherwise, old age begins even at the age of 30. Well, I ask people, why are you walking like this? They say we have lots of pain in our knee. What happens? The joints are getting degenerated. Muscles are also getting weaker. And so the pain starts. There has to be some reason for all these things. First of all, unhealthy food. Sedentary lifestyle. Overweight of your body. Joint has to take more than what joint is structured for. You see, pair of tight shoes and more than that, tight fitting clothes, no freedom of movements, and that also causes lots of problems. Nowadays, we hardly exercise our body. We are exercising our mind too much. Lack of exercise at that physical level will create pain in your knee joint. So I'll give you some tips. Reduce your long sitting position. Become alert and aware. Every half an hour, just get up. Walk a little bit, go up to window, come back, go and drink water and come back, but move, and that would help very much. Now I give you some physical tips. Getting up and walking, coming is one thing. Sitting on your chair itself, push your chair a little back and stretch your legs a bit. When you stretch your legs, just lift your legs straight up a bit from the ground. Stay there for some time. Just do this. While working, intermittent, you should be doing this. When you are sitting on the chair, try and bring your leg up 90 degree. Stay there and come down. Similarly, for some time, try and stretch your legs and put your leg on the other chair or on some such area where you are resting your foot. And that also will help your knee pain. You see, knee pain is not just a physical thing, let me tell you. If mind gets disturbed, mind is anxious, angry, hurt, that's what happens, you know. Your muscles become tight, arteries become narrow. When muscles get tight, joints come closer and nerves are getting pressed, and so it gives you more pain. So what you should do is relax yourself. Don't mentally get affected like this. Rather, try and see that you put your hand, palm on your knee. Just give love to your knee. Just give warmth to your knee. You see, irrespective of your pain, you have pain, but you have to work. And so put your mind at work, and that itself would help you. When mind is in pain, it increases pain. And so remove that mind and focus on your work properly. Some of the yoga techniques which would help you to manage this stress and negativity are, number one, try and listen to some sound around, which is called as Yogendra Nishpanda Bhav. Do that. Second, try and do what is called as Brahmari Pranayam. Try and see that you take some break from your stressful job and listen to some soulful music. You see, learn to take your pain little differently. You have pain in your one joint, your knee. Rest of the joints have no pain, no? So why are you so much negative about it? In the office atmosphere, if the mind is so tensed and negative about that one pain, it is going to affect the whole working of the office. Some research has been done. They took x-ray of 100 such people who are working in the building construction. And the x-ray showed lots of degeneration in their joints. But when we asked them, do you have a pain? They say, we have no pain. Against it, 100 x-rays were taken of all those who are working in the office. Joints were quite healthy, little degeneration, little beginning of osteoarthritis. And they say we have excruciating pain. Now what is this? It is not the problem in the body. The problem is in the mind. Mentally, when we take things so negatively, little problem and we highlight it, we create more problem. And in the organization, you may have pain, but if you feel you have a pain, I have noticed that with pain, person stops breathing only because that pain is too much for him. So take a long breath to reduce that pain. And once you will breathe in fully and say, I'm taking my pain and breathing out and releasing my pain, try and do that and you will see that your pain is definitely reduced. So work on yourself. Work to see that you don't feel pain while working, and you will not feel pain, I guarantee you. So understand these two techniques well. Sitting on the chair, your legs are folded, lift your leg up and down. Do this 10 to 20 times. Second, push your chair back and make your legs straight. And then lift your leg up and down without folding. When you are up, stay there for 10 seconds and bring it down and rest. And this would help relieving your pain. Keep your leg up on the other chair and rest for some time. Understand these other two techniques also, which is called as Nishpanda Bhav, motionless state of mind. Just listen to the sound which are there in the atmosphere. And second, a pranayama, which is called as Bhramari Pranayama, where you are inhaling, holding your breath and creating a sound like Bhramar. Do it for some time. That also would help mind to get arrested. Mind would be free from stress and tension. Do these techniques and benefit yourself. Knee pain could be due to several things. If it is a degeneration because of old age, then you do movements and that would help you, but do it very slowly. If it is rheumatoid arthritis, don't touch that pain. Use other joints, but not that joint. Just give warmth and rest to that part. If it is osteoporosis, then you should do all the exercises, only don't repeat them. Little caution that don't overdo any things. Your body has its own language to offer. When you do, next day if it pains you more, that means you have done more. So give warmth and rest. And second, when you are doing Nishpanda Bhav, closing your eyes and listening to the sound, you will feel sleepy. Don't do that. Rather, remain alert and listen. If you feel you are feeling sleepy, open your eyes and start doing your work. With yoga, your muscles, ligaments, tendons, they get stronger. And so, this increases the longevity of your knee joint. Yoga helps to improve blood circulation by which it releases the stress and tension of that area. All you should do is to see that you follow the path of yoga and your life would become definitely better, superior. Please leave your comments below and we shall get back to you. Namaskar.